The state legislator wants to bag the use of plastic bags in Arkansas supermarkets. Republican Representative Danny Altus filed the bill yesterday, but how would grocery stores be affected and how many customers already use cloth grocery bags? We sent Channel 7's Janelle Lilly to find out and give us the answers to those questions. Janelle?
Well, Christina, in all the time that I spent at the store today, only a handful of customers chose these reusable or paper bags. The manager tells me paper costs the store about three times as much money, and the majority of his customers prefer plastic.
$6 even. Thank you, ma'am. Have a great day and come back.
For 2 years, Judy's been greeting customers, scanning barcodes, and bagging groceries, usually with plastic.
So we do get a lot of customers that have their own bags, but the majority is plastic.
On an average day, a store like this will use about 5,000 bags. Most, according to Representative Danny Altus, wind up in a landfill.
I got 578 to change back.
That's why he filed a bill to ban the bags in Arkansas. Okay.
We do have paper.
Customer Mary D'Amico was one of the few who didn't choose plastic today.
In terms of plastic bags, I don't always know where to bring them. If I do want to recycle them, and then it's an extra trip.
D'Amico says she's in favor of bagging the bags, but thinks it might be tough to convince most shoppers.
It may be upset some people because that's what they're used to, but I think that that's probably a good way to show people that that's not the best thing for the environment.
That may be so, but there's a lot of customers to convince. Judy says it's convenience, not conscientiousness, that moves the checkout lane.
They're not so into it. Just whatever's here to put the groceries in at the time of purchase is what they want.
If the bill passes, we'll be asking paper or cloth by January 2014. Scott.
Janelle, this will be a big undertaking if it passes, too. You think about all the places you get plastic bags, like a mall, a convenience store. Would it just be supermarkets, though?
Yeah, well, according to the bill, the only stores that would be affected would be supermarkets, stores larger than 10,000 square feet with a pharmacy on site, and convenience stores that sell food.
All right, we'll wait and see as the session moves forward. Janelle, thank you.